Welcome to the Student Academic Learning Services video on the bottoms-up factoring method for trinomials. In this video, we're simply going to go through an example using the bottoms-up factoring method. Our example is 6x squared plus 13x minus 5. The very first thing we're going to do is see if we can common factor anything out of this particular trinomial. As there is nothing that goes into 6, 13, or negative 5, and they don't share a common variable, we don't have a common factor, so we're going to start factoring this as is. The next step in the bottoms-up factoring method is to just draw an x on the page. You can see we already have one in the middle. And the first thing we're going to do with this is we're going to take the coefficient of our middle term, so that 13, we're going to take that and place it in the top section of our x. The next step will be to take the product of our first and last terms, so 6 times negative 5, and we're going to place that in the bottom section of the x, so 6 times negative 5 gives us negative 30. Our next step in the method is to figure out two numbers that multiply to negative 30 and add to 13. So if we look at all the numbers that multiply to 30, we see that 2 and 15 are the numbers that we want to look at here. So if we have positive 15 and negative 2, they will multiply to negative 30 and they'll add to positive 13, so that's what we're going to use. We're going to take one of those numbers and place it in the left-hand section and take the other number and place it in the right-hand section. We could have flipped these and put the negative 2 on the left-hand side or the positive 15 on the right-hand side. It makes no difference. Our next step is to take our leading coefficient, so the 6, and we are going to place that under the 15 and the negative 2, essentially creating two fractions. Once we have our two fractions, we now want to convert them to lowest terms. So on the left-hand side, we have 15 over 6. Dividing both of those by 3, we get 5 over 2. And on the right-hand side, we have negative 2 over 6. Dividing both of them by 2 will give us negative 1 over 3. Now, we go bottoms up. This is where the method gets its name. And the 2 in the left-hand section on the denominator is going to be our leading term in our factored bracket. So the 2 becomes the first term and we just attach an x to it, and the 5 becomes our second term. Okay, and on the right hand side, our 3, the denominator, is going to become our leading bracket, or our leading term in the bracket, and the negative 1 becomes the second term. So we get 3x minus 1. Very important to remember the signs here. This wouldn't be correct if we had said positive 1 in that second bracket. Now that we have our factors, we want to check to make sure that they're right. We do that by expanding our factors out, and if we get back to our original trinomial, we know we're correct. So using FOIL, we have 2x times 3x gives us 6x squared. 2x times negative 1 gives us negative 2x. Positive 5 times 3x gives us positive 15x. And lastly, positive 5 times negative 1 gives us negative 5. Combining the like terms, we come up with 6x squared plus 13x minus 5. This is our original trinomial, so that we know the factors of 2x plus 5 and 3x minus 1 are the correct factors. This concludes our video on the bottoms-up method for factoring trinomials. If you have any questions on the material covered in this video, I strongly encourage you to come by the SAL Center and make an appointment with the appropriate learning skills advisor. Thanks for watching.